is the best described in Revelation? What that means 666, which is a trademark. Who is the Antichrist? Who will be the end of time? My answer is clear, sharp and clear. I am Romano Amodeo, a father and God. The Holy Spirit descended in a sinful flesh, and the maximum possible, the best, and the Antichrist to dissolve all their shadows. When light enters the darkness, there is no darkness. There is no evil that can obscure that light. This was the technique that God set when he came in me and he made his own my character, my puppet. God has played my character so that he revealed the truth absolute. In this way, by force alone, in this total truth, all evil would be destroyed for every living man. First of all, I will totally destroy all evil with the simple use of my reason alone. Then I'll show why. I am the best, as described in Revelation. The 666 of its brand, and the long-awaited Antichrist at the end of the time. But before I tell you what the truth absolute is in itself, the truth is absolute one when it not depend on any truth, so that if something is judged true, then it is certainly true also what is exactly equal and opposite truth. There is no truth that could be absolute one, because it belongs to God, who is the absolute in himself. Therefore, it cannot exist a truth if it is not existing in the absolute also its opposite, the lie of a lie. In fact, where all is himself, the true of the true is the true, and the false of the false is the true. God is a proponent of absolute freedom. He compels everything in way that while he is bending, he is giving freedom simultaneously through the constraints imposed to the constraints themselves. God created a complex reality. With this, he drew from nothing all things. All of them were equal and opposite, as matter and antimatter, in the field of physics, and as good and evil in the spiritual context. The existence of two things exactly equal and opposite means that everything is relative. Everything is existing only until you add together the opposite minus one and plus one, and you restore the truth of the absolute zero of imbalance. Everything is perfect balance. Is in perfect balance, but until there is not the harvest of what has been sown, it seems that an enemy has sown tares in the wheat field. Now, there is the grain that exists such as wheat, and There are the weeds that exist as the weeds. The absolute freedom that has been allowed for everything to be herself brings, in other words, a bad man to be bad in himself and therefore mainly against himself. This, at the end, will bring him to correct his same nature. You've read the Bible. God gave everything to Adam and Eve, but with one condition, not to eat of the tree of knowledge of God and evil. Until Adam and Eve did not distinguish one from the other, they had confidence in God, even when it was up to them to love an evil. Even in that situation, Adam and Eve lived in the trust in God. Now, God gave Adam and Eve the freedom to refuse. When God allowed them to make mistakes, then He gave them a huge gift, the free will. Free will, the real one. It is not that of being able to do what is absolutely not acceptable to God. If God allows man to make a mistake, God does not do it with the ultimate aim of punishing those who have clung to that choice. If God ought to punish, He would have given Adam and Eve a false freedom. In fact, if I give you true freedom, later I cannot ask you if you've taken into account what is good or bad in my opinion. No one makes deliberately evil by recognizing it as evil. Who else is simply making confusion between God and evil, understood in their own way, and not how they really are? Well, if God allows our days the arrival of the Antichrist, therefore of the beast described in Revelation, through the number 666, God does not introduce a bad thing, if not to exorcise the evil through that introduction. Only God can enter in such absolute evil, but only to exorcise the best and destroy such an Antichrist. Therefore, then you should expect that at the end of time God Himself should appear under these so false and negative characters. The Absolute, willing to enter personally into the relative world, will assume the greatest possible contradiction. That contradiction that wasn't assumed completely in Jesus Christ, the Son that was designed only as a sign of a contradiction for the other men and not in Himself. In fact, Jesus Christ suffered only the curse of wood and got the freedom of the sin of the others by suffering for His own Calvary. On the contrary, the Father and the Holy Spirit should have assumed the sin in themselves by presenting themselves in a character that should have been their personal contradiction, and no more of the others. Jesus said it. Who is without sins can punish the others. So, the Father and the Holy Spirit, presenting themselves as sinners, should have no possible power to punish the others, especially because only one is the Creator, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. The men are only puppets, characters of a design that is only divine. Men are without a true responsibility about what is really made. They have only the spiritual sin to have desired what is not good for everyone, but only for themselves. Therefore, having a desire and simultaneously having the full impossibility to translate the willing in the action. Now, in two persons, of the Father and of the Holy Spirit, there was God incarnated in myself. There was truly Jesus who returned in myself. Like Saint Luke wrote, this has happened in the same way in which Jesus was seen to ascend in the time, in the sky. For me, two airplanes were descending in Rio de Janeiro by completing the raid Rome-Rio, while in road Pome-Rio, with Rome-Rio equal to Pome-Rio, Father and the Holy Spirit were descending in my body, in my person. And in the sky, the greatest aurora borealis of the modern time was seen flashing in the night, from east to west, in Europe, Africa, Asia, and America. In the year 38, the 1st January, Romano, myself, was born, as it is written in Genesis 38, like my year of birth. Genesis 38 describes the birth of a pair of twins, one the Jesus ancestor, who was the second, but was compelled to go out to appear in the world by fifth. Who was the first, was a son of Er, and at presented out a hand that in Italian is mano, alluding so to the Italian Er mano, Romano, myself. Well, Romano is 66 in the Italian Kabbalah, which sees quantity to the letters, and the sum is 66. The best is 666, where 6 in Italian is red, sei, which means you are. Therefore, 666 is meaning sei Romano, you are Romano, otherwise you are 66, otherwise you are the Italian Er Mano of Genesis 38, you built in the year 38. That refers to the birth of the ancestor of Jesus in the moment of the foundation of the God people, when exactly and again 66 Pearsons, born out of the blood of Israel, Jacob, were entering in Egypt, as it is written in the Bible. Well, Romano is also Antichrist in the meaning of anti, as before, by two reasons. One is that the father in myself is before his son. The second one is that our time is before that of Jesus, in the direction of the Spirit, equal and contrary to that of the water, as Jesus explained to Nicodemo in Gospel of St. John, chapter 3. And now I'll explain why we all are anti-Christ before of the Christ's birth. I'll do by using the principles of the science, and precisely the third principle of the dynamic love, that is named of action and reaction. According to it, the real action between them, considered as one and minus one in their inverse proceeding, is the product which get the result of the negative minus one of a coming back in the time. Since the action is negative one, but we perceive its reaction, we perceive as the positive plus one the real action, that is minus one in itself. Therefore, we are perceiving the positive proceeding of matter and electricity toward the death of the body, because the real action is the returning from the apparent death toward the apparent birth, toward the apparent but the true beginning. As Jesus said, truly, first ones are those that appear to be the last ones. So we all seem to be after of the Jesus birth, but we are before his spiritual birth, because we are after only in the line of the proceeding of the matter, while our to-be is spiritual, is in the negative proceeding of the antimatter. Therefore, we all are before, are anti-Christ, and our time is that of his father, living in myself and in my to-be, the best, the 666 of you are 66, equal Romano. Of myself, Saint Malachy wrote, he named myself Pietro Romano, would take the place of last Pope, after the 111, recognized as Benedict XVI. In fact, Pietro is the acronym of Paolo, Jesus, Emmanuel, Torquato, Romano. In these five names, Paolo, Torquato and Romano are my own, while Jesus, Emmanuel, is born in another character, but is Holy Spirit that is contained in myself, in pure power to exist. Since in 666 we have three numbers six, we have one and more six and six, whose sum is 12. Therefore, the beast 666 is 1 and 12, so 112, the character coming after the Pope, 111. And who is Pietro Romano? Myself. But now I have to explain in what way my character is able to save this very difficult situation. Saving the same God who entered in my immense limit. My salvation cannot be only for myself, but generalized. This is the aim of my character. In part, I have already said it and given its solution. Our world is returning to its divine origin. God has already put in action the antimatter annulling our real dresses to give inner divine dresses that could be ideal forever. But we are perceiving the inverse matter of a real body that is going to die. We are perceiving the reaction and not the action. We are perceiving the apparent lie of a lie. Our truth is the spirit, is the antimatter, but we are able to perceive the matter in its dynamic and not that of the spirit and not that of the antimatter. We cannot perceive our proceeding if not through what is external. And so, if I go towards the mountain, is this mountain that seems to move toward myself, and it is the Mohammed's miracle. The fundamental action is of God, is a centripetal force of magnetic attraction, as the universal gravitation, but we are able to perceive the flight of the galaxies, which is perceived in their light and matter. The evil devil is the apparent lord of this world that is showing its immense lie. Therefore, if we are perceiving the advent of Satan, he is God who is arriving but who is appearing inversely. When every man is praying God to save him, he is already in his salvation. If going on in the apparent time of the future, the same man observes the apparent not help of God, as if he'd been absent, this man must know that he has gone in the past time of the spirit and not in its future. The real future of the spirit is what we think is the pastime. The time of Jesus' existence is in our real future and not in the pastime. We know everything of our true future, but we ignore only the past, whose extreme is our true beginning. That seems the end, but is the true beginning by a design that exists in all its part and its whole. I, while am going to be recognized as Pietro Romano and the others, am in my full salvation. But this immense cross is in my destiny. A day will come in which I'll put in my cross. But afterward, I also will have my resurrection. It will be not a real one as that of Jesus, but will be a spiritual resurrection by this cross named the best 666 of the Antichrist. Nobody is so loving towards the Son of the Father, who is living in myself. But what it matters? I'll be judged against Christ before of my resurrection. I'll be condemned